السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. All praises to Allah for all the blessings and for allowing us to be here today in this blessed event. I want to first of all congratulate all the Huffaz, my close friends, for this landmark day in their lives. But as a reminder to them and myself that this is not the end, but rather the start of their knowledge, of the journey of knowledge. And inshallah, there's more to come. I'd also like to thank everyone here today, all the guests, parents, and all the people from the Hifz class. Inshallah, today I'll be indeed talking about the Quran and how superior it is and the virtues of memorizing the Quran. My dear brothers in Islam, this Quran is special in many ways. It is superior to other books in many ways. One way is the way Allah has written this Quran. Allah says in the Quran,
قُلْ لَئِنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا.
He says, say, if men and jinn should combine together to bring the like of this Qur'an, they could not bring the like of it, though some of them were aiders of others. Allah justifies in this ayah that not anyone in the history of humanity, nor in the future of humanity, even if they all work together, they would still not be able to compile not even a verse like the speech of Allah. Even the polytheists at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who were masters at the Arabic language, they couldn't make a verse, let alone a book like this. Allah does what we can't do, and this gives us another reason why we worship Him. The Quran is also a cure to any disease. Allah says in the Quran,
وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا.
He says, what we are sending down in the course of revealing the Quran is a healing and a grace for those who have faith, but it adds only unto the ruin of the wrongdoers. Allah says in the Quran that this Quran, this book of Allah, the speech of Allah, is a cure to any disease, any illness, not only to a physical illness, but also for the heart and the soul. We all know some of the miraculous ways Allah has cured someone in the past, including our beloved prophets. Another way the Quran is superior to other books is in Surah Hijr. Allah says,
إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ.
Surely we sent down the dhikr. In this, it means the Quran, and we are surely its guardian. This Quran, since Allah revealed this to a Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, verse by verse, not a single letter has been changed. If all of the Quran were to disappear today, the Huffaz, the people who have memorized the Quran, would be able to come together and compile it again. This is not the same with the other books of other religions. So the fact that the Quran has been protected and memorized and been learned by the Quran and been learned by the Huffaz and not been changed by a single letter is another superiority to other books. There are many more ways that the Quran is superior to all other texts in the world, but because of time, I won't be able to mention all of them. Those who have memorized the Quran, the special word of Allah, Allah has given them many virtues and rewards. There's a hadith narrated by Abdullah ibn Umar that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said,
يُقَالُ يَعْنِي لِصَاحِبِ الْقُرْآنِ اقْرَأْ وَارْتَقِ وَرَتِّلْ كَمَا كُنْتَ تُرَتِّلْ فِي الدُّنْيَا فِنَّ مَنْزِلَتَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَأُ بِهَا.
Allah says, it shall be said for the ones who have memorized the Quran, recite and rise up. Recite as you would recite in the world, for indeed your ranks shall be at the last ayah recited. On the day of Qiyamah, the Huffaz, they will be asked to read from what they have learned. All the way from the start of Surah Fatiha to the end of Surah An-Nas. And how much they are able to read, that is their rank on the Day of Judgment. There's another hadith from Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, and he reports that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قرأ القرآن واستظهره فأحل حلاله وحرم حرامه أدخله الله به الجنة وشفعه في عشرة من أهل بيته كلهم وجبت له النار. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever reads the Quran, memorizes it, regards it permissible as permissible, and regards it impermissible as impermissible, Allah Ta'ala will enter him into Jannah and allow him to intercede for 10 family members who are destined for Jahannam. This hadith is weak, but by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's bounty and rewards, we are hopeful. Another hadith is narrated that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever reads the Quran, memorizes it, and acts upon it, on the day of judgment, he will be clad by angels with a crown of light. Its light is like the sunlight, and his parents will be clad with two garments, better than the whole world and whatever it contains. So they would amazingly ask, what action did we do to deserve this? They will be told, because your son memorized the Quran. Subhanallah. These are the rewards from Allah. Just in these three hadith, and there are many more we can find, we see the mercy of Allah and the reward of Allah. Our rank in Jannah will be decided by how much of the Quran we read. If we read it all in one go, we are the highest rank of humanity. Allah also will allow us to save those who we loved in this dunya, those who we found happiness with in this dunya, our family members who are destined for punishment and the torture of Allah, and we will bring them with us to Jannah. Also on the day of Qiyamah, the Huffaz will be standing out. They will have crowns like the sunlight, and their parents, those who we want to make proud of in this dunya, they will be wearing garments like none other. My dear brothers, does this still not appeal to our hearts? If not, then you are lost in this world. Allah has also given a reward to those who teach the Quran. In a very famous hadith that I'm sure we all know, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best among you, the Muslims, are those who learn the Quran and teach it. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the best upon all Muslims are the ones who learn the Quran, stay connected with it, and then teach it, so that the people after them may also know the Quran, and so they can spread it on upon generations and generations. However, to all these rewards, there is a condition, my dear brothers. Without this condition, then these beautiful rewards won't be for you. You have to act upon this Quran, because in the Quran is the way of life for a Muslim who wants Jannah. The hadith narrated by Abu Malik al-Harith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Quran hujjatun laka aw alayk. The Quran on the Day of Judgment could either intercede for us or against us on the Day of Judgment. So my dear brothers, if you want to be on the Quran, if you want the Quran on your side, then act upon it just like the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because if we follow them, like how they followed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will be successful in our lives and destined for Jannah. And inshallah, I'll finish here due to time. And may Allah guide us all to the right path. May Allah reward us for our attendance in this blessed event and allow us to gain beneficial knowledge. May Allah connect us with the Qur'an, learn it, act upon it, and teach it, so that we will be raised on the Day of Judgment and the hereafter, and also so it will boost us in this dunya. Barakallahu feek. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.